This is a 2005 Pontiac Vibe with a 1zz-FE 1.8-liter engine made by Toyota. This car is essentially the same car as a Toyota Matrix or a Toyota Corolla of the same year. In this video, we are doing the timing chain tensioner on this car, and you'll notice that the front passenger side wheel is off. If you keep watching, you'll see why. The timing chain tensioner is on the timing cover or timing chain side of the engine, which is this side right here. And it is on the back of the engine, between the engine and the firewall, and you cannot see it. Okay, there's no way to see it clearly from up here, even with a light. It's very difficult to see. Right, in fact, you just can't see it from up here. Even looking up from underneath the engine, it's difficult to get a good view of the location of the timing chain tensioner. And it is above the power steering pump, and you can just barely make out the two studs that hold it in, where the light is shining. But what you can sort of plainly see is that there is a mess of oil that is leaking out from the location of the timing chain tensioner. This is very common, and I'll show you why. This is a brand new replacement part for the timing chain tensioner. This is the flange that is on the outside of the engine, and this shaft inserts right into the engine. And the only thing that keeps oil from leaking out is this rubber O-ring. Over time, this O-ring gets cooked and it hardens and shrinks, and it allows oil to leak out. So you can try to just replace this O-ring, but doing that, I have not had much success in stopping the leakage. I don't know why. So I just replaced the entire tensioner with an aftermarket part. So I want to show you an important feature of this tensioner. It has this latch, okay, and this latch keeps the tensioner in the latch state, and that is the state that it needs to be in for installation. So to get it into the latch state, you have this stop right here. As you press down the plunger, you pull back on the latch, and then the piston can go all the way down. You can put the latch in place, and this is the state that the tensioner has to be in order to insert it into the engine. To remove the tensioner, I'm going to reach down with this 10 millimeter ratchet wrench. There are two nuts with 10 millimeter head on 6 millimeter studs that you can unfasten to remove the tensioner. And you can feel for them right down underneath here. Again, it's impossible to really get a line of sight on them. You just have to feel around for them. Looking down here from the side of the timing cover, you can see that flange that I'm shining the light on, and you can see the top stud. And I've removed both nuts, and the tensioner is not moving. But you can see there's a gap right there between the head, or between the timing cover and the flange of the tensioner. You can reach down with a long screwdriver and put it in that gap and just pry gently, and that will set the tensioner in motion coming out of the timing cover. This is the long screwdriver that I'm referring to. You can see how I put the blade right in the gap, and I can just pry gently, and this starts the tensioner moving so it can be removed. And there the tensioner has slid out sufficiently so you can see its O-ring and the shaft. Here is the old tensioner. You can see there's nothing visibly wrong with it is just allowing oil to get through past that O-ring. Here is the new one with the old one side by side. And before I put the new one in, I'm going to wet it down with some engine oil just to lubricate the O-ring so it does not get damaged on insertion. So we've inserted the new tensioner. By the way, there's only one way that the tensioner will fit into the timing cover, okay, so you don't have to worry about putting it upside down. It will not line up upside down, okay. And now the burning question on your mind should be, how do we release this latch so that the tensioner can resume its function? That's a very good question. There's two ways that you can release this latch. One way is that you can remove the valve cover and you reach straight down with a long screwdriver and you apply pressure on the timing chain guide, which pushes onto the tensioner, and then when the tensioner is pushed down slightly, that causes the latch to fall back and the tensioner releases. Okay, so you would do this if you were in the process of doing the valve cover gasket at the same time, which we are not. So there's another method that you can use, and this is why I have the wheel off. The reason I removed the wheel is so that I can access the crankshaft pulley easily. And now, if I give the pulley a quick jog backward, an eighth of a turn or no more than a quarter turn, then this will apply tension to the timing chain guide. This will release the latch on the tensioner. And if you're in a sufficiently quiet environment, then you'll be able to hear the click as the tensioner releases and pushes forward. Okay, so this is a socket with 19 millimeter hex head. It fits right onto the crankshaft bolt. And it's a little bit noisy in here. Let's go ahead and try that. Again, you turn backwards. Okay, so that did not do it. Let's turn back to where we were. And let's try that again. So that did not do it. That should have been enough to do it right there. That should have been enough to do it right there. And we're going to call it good. So this completes the repair. Thank you for watching. We started the car and verified that it runs normally. And it's been known that if the tensioner does not release, that the valves get bent on startup. This has happened. So be very wary of what you do with this tensioner replacement. You must absolutely make sure that you release the tensioner. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe.